I've had an idea. Why don't we scribe some skirtings?
What's the problem?
Hello!
Hello!
And welcome back to the Home Improvement Channel. And today I'm going to be one of your hosts, I'm Brad.
I'm Jack.
And I feel like I
am still in the battle.
And on today's episode, we will be showing you, Phil,
how to scribe and turn a corner on skirtings
using three
different methods.
So if you suss one of these methods out, it will help you out. All three of them are really good methods. They all work, and it will help you out with your skirtings. Let's get to it.
First step to a internal scribe is to put a 45. Not that the angle's important. The angle's not important, and I'll tell you why in a minute. But we're going to put a 45 away from the face of the skirting, and it doesn't matter what type. What design or pattern, just want a 45. So if I do it on this saw, it's got a really deep cut on it. We're gonna set the saw to 45. We're gonna switch that hover on.
Dust extraction.
We're gonna put our goggles on. Keep your fingers away. One more thing. One more thing before I make this cut. So, if you're right-handed or whatever, and you're using a saw with your right hand, you want to hold the piece with your left hand. If you need to cut on the left side, like this, this is not acceptable. This is not, don't do that.
Too dangerous.
Hold with your right and cut with your left. Never cross your arms on a saw, because you'll be like, right, let's make our cut, put our goggles on. Right, so, you ready? Right, so if your saw's got a deep cut, that's what you're going to do. And you see, I've cut away from the face. And what that's given us is a guide for our scribe. We're going to cut up to this white line. And that'll give us a perfect scribe. So this one is for people that have got a smaller saw that hasn't got a really deep cut on it. So you're going to tip your saw to 45. Tighten up your bevel. Set your saw. Clear your guides that way, because they're in the way. And then you're going to bring your piece down, take your little piece off.
Dust.
And that leaves exactly the same finish, but it's just done on the bevel rather than the... Right, so now you're at this stage where you've put your 45 away from the face of your material. And what we're going to be taking off is all of this. And as Jack said earlier, if you have got an unprimed piece, you could put a pencil line along that edge and it'll make it easier to follow. And when we do cut this, we're not cutting at 90 degrees like that. We're actually back cutting like that. And what that does, that allows for any imperfections on the internal. Right, so I've done this straight run here quickly just to show you what I'm doing. So if you come around the front here, you can see I've actually coped it back rather than square. And then we're going to do the same on every little detail on here, except on this face here on the top, we're actually going to cut that at 90. I'm going to take this little corner off, because that will help the piece sit against the next piece. Now you can do this in sections, but this saw's not very good, I'll be completely honest with you. Some people say, oh, why'd you do it from down? I don't know, that's what I feel comfortable doing. So, if you look at the top of this now, you'll see we've got the pattern of the skirting we're going against, but we've actually cut backwards. We're not 90 degrees down. We're all of our cuts are back. All right? So if we take a piece of the same skirting, Brad comes around here, you'll see that we fit in there, but no matter what we do with this, we're still tight. So if you imagine one of your walls is off by a few degrees, or obviously when you start getting into compound miters, it's going to be terrible. We're talking about slight imperfections in the walls, so that allows movement, and you can fine tune this. So if you're is walls tip like this, you can actually sand that back and it'll bring it back in tight. Right, yeah, that's one method. So next we'll do the jigsaw method, which is exactly the same thing. Start with your 45 and we'll get Brad on that one so he can have a go, and we'll see you on that.
Same method, but we're just going to tip the jigsaw in to what Phil just said, and then we're going to follow the line. And that's a wrap from the Home Improvements channel. Three different methods.
I didn't get to do one.
Meh. So. What did you do for your method, Jack?
I didn't get to do one. But I did say when the next is going, there is spray valve, which they definitely get.
Cheers. So if you're liking our videos, please hit the like button and the subscribe button.
And all the ticket thing.
Until the next time, we'll see you on the next one.
Hit that bell. Boom. Hello.